old god powers plus new god powers equals god-er powers? Stalingrad 3 has been updated to the newest patch, and he brings all of his amazing units as well as their amazing god powers to the new DLC. Oh, and if you think it's just a simple port, you have no idea what you're about to see. So, the Stalingrad 3 mod has finally been updated to the brand new update, the DLC, the bug DLC, and it has given us some changes to the developer god powers panel. But on top of that, he's also added a new unit, and that's this unit right here, the flail unit. And it seems like it has working bendable flails, which is very, very interesting. Now, Stalingrad 3 is filled with a bunch of really cool modded units, which also gives us very cool modded god powers on top of other things. Let's take a look at these flail units and actions. Do they wield their flails? Oh my god, the chain's coming apart. What is wrong with the flails? So it does kind of have... Oh my god, this is actually a little bit weirder than I expected. Hold on, I can't see anything. There's too many units. Give me one flailer each. Let me watch these flails in action. Now, a flail is supposed to like move and bend, but as you can see, the chains actually like break apart. They don't stay together. It seems like the flail is built in about 3 or 4 different segments, and they're not really like flailing each other. They're more like smacking their arms at each other. The units almost work, and the flails, I can just capture a moment. The flails actually come apart. That'd be very cool. Flail, do a flail thing. This is not how you fight with flails, guys. It's like you're like WWE wrestling and happen to be holding these things. Yeah, this is not how flailing's supposed to work. So you guys remember that Stalingrad 3 has all the really cool, crazy modded units. We have the brand new Zeus with color-coordinated lightning bolts, or bright pink. You've got the God of War, Ares, and then you got Apollo, this archer god. But there was another one added, and I wasn't aware. It's Poseidon, and check out Poseidon's trident. Now, what does Poseidon do? I don't really know. Poseidon seems to give off this white, foggy bit. Isn't that the fog from the Necromancer? Doesn't it, like, drain life over time? The pink lightning bolts from the brand new Zeus is phenomenal. I love this color coordinated to the faction. So if you have blue Zeus versus red Zeus, you'll actually see color coordinated lightning bolts. Now, these Poseidons don't seem to do anything else other than like maybe a ground pound and then that fog ability. So now you're wondering yourself, Crow, what about this new god power stuff you promised? So if we take a look at our lovely developer panel, we move over to, not the grab, even though we know the hand of God is amazing, we move over to the shoot panel, and the shoot panel has projectiles and modes. Before I show you all the projectiles, I'm going to show you the two new modes that Stalingrad 3 has added. Regular mode, you've got tap, which boom, summons an arrow. Then you have spray, which boom, actually spray looks like that, and actually goes out in different directions. See, sprays out in different directions. Then you have beam, which creates a very rapid fire thing. So you can go slow-mo and go beam, 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 beam. Look at that, see, a beam of arrows. After the beam, you have super spray, which becomes like a crazy shotgun blast, and it goes out in all different directions. Then you have super beam, which is a really fast firing beam. But you'd think that that's fast? No, we can go faster than super beam. Let me demonstrate super beam, okay? Demonstrate super beam just like that. There's super beam. What about death beam? Death beam is even tighter than super beam. This was added in Stalingrad 3. Death beam is like super beam, but on like insane amounts of power, like energy drinks. It's super beam on energy drinks. As you can see, death beam is just unfair and insane. And then on top of that, there is also death spray. And death spray is a shotgun blast, unlike the witch of anything. Let me go full speed. It goes out in every direction. Let me look straight down. The spread is insane. It spreads below you and above you in every single direction. It is just crazy. And if you slow down time, you can see it much more clearly. And if I slow down time even more, it gets even tighter. So hold on. The rate of fire is unaffected by time. Maximum slow-mo creates this disgusting spread of death spray. And then regular speed, it spreads out normally. So that's interesting. Hold on. Can we do some crazy things with this? So Stalingrad 3 gives you cool units, and it gives you new ways of doing god powers, but it also gives you something even more interesting than that. Let's keep on death spray, because death spray sounds most fun. Let me show you the types of projectiles. Let me just zoom in here on the screen so you can read it nice and easily. We've got bow. You've got spear, musket, balloon bow, firework, bomb. Yeah, that's all good. That's all good. But guess what happens? Super peasant ball projectile. Void arrow all of these Stalingrad 3 god powers from the old school original god power are now available here. So if I just do void arrow and I go maximum slow-mo and I death spray fire out. Oh. Oh no. What am I doing? Guys, hold on. I'm gonna shoot this for a little bit longer and then we're gonna pause time and I'm gonna show you the sheer amount of void arrows. Here, let's put those in regular slow-mo as they fall to the earth and blanket the battlefield in the old school black hole. Remember when we called this the old school black hole? See, so again, when you do this in full speed, this is what it looks like. It's kind of like, it's like a polite sprinkling of rain, right? It's a beautiful, like, spring sunshine rain. This is okay. But when you do slow-mo, you fire them out even denser. The rate of fire is unaffected by time. It still fires the same number of arrows per second. But when you slow time, that happens to be even more arrows. But again, if I go all the way up here, oh, this is probably a bad idea. Maximum slow-mo. I'm just going to power up this attack for a few seconds. Hold on a second. Yep, okay, I think this is good enough. Pause. Oh, baby. Here we go. Slow-mo, arrows coming down. I'm going down with the arrows, baby. We're going to watch these arrows impact the battlefield. This is going to be awesome. Here we go. Full impact. Just black. Just an ocean of black. And then sucked in. So, as you can see, you've got new modes of fire and new attacks. You've got all the Stalingrad 3 attacks. To take these powers for a spin, I have downloaded something called the Very Impossible Campaign. Here is the first level of the Very Impossible Campaign, complete with a whole bunch of travel units, and they give me 150 currency to buy units. I can't even buy Larry, guys. Now, we've got this poor little farmer here, and something just reminded me. Apparently, since now everyone has access to a form of god powers, thanks to the DLC, impossible campaigns are now no longer impossible. What we're going to do is we're going to find unique ways to wipe out these armies with the new powers that are included with the mod. Juggernaut M16 Bullet. You know what this needs? This needs Death Beam. The Juggernaut M16 Bullet. Let's take a look and see how well this works. I'm going to do regular slow-mo and I'm going to... Oh my goodness. I'm a machine gun. I'm a human. Hold on. Can I not turn the farmer into... Oh, I can't do slow-mo. Oh, but I can still fire the farmer shooting machine guns. Oh, pause. Oh God, we're gonna lose. This farmer's dead. I got no way to save him now. We've got no way to save this farmer. There's too many units. There's these M16s, these bullets don't deal enough damage. The farmer's gonna die. The farmer, how is the farmer not dead? Hold on. Do I have immortal units on? I might have immortal units on. Let's just go into the settings and go to the DLC bugs. And look, make units not die is on. That's awkward. Kind of hard to win campaigns. Let's try this again. Juggernaut, M16 bullets, death beam, go. Now we're going to see just how well these bullets do with a death beam as I'm mowing down the front army using all this machine gun fire. Now, if I wanted even tighter bullet spread, I would do maximum slow-mo. Oh. Oh, look at the bullets coming out of me, guys. It is just... What? It's like... You know how you have a clip of... Not a clip, but what's the word I want to use? This sheet. I use the word sheet, which is not the right word. When you have those big, giant machine guns that get fed bullets, like a sheet of bullets into the side of them, that's what it kind of looks like coming out of me right now. Clearly, that's not the right English to describe these bullets, but that's the only way I know how to describe what I'm playing with right now. Firing these massive amounts of M16 bullets thanks to the Stalingrad 3 mod. Let's just get these mammoths down and then make sure I shoot the enemies and not my lovely single farmer. M16 bullets completely wiping out the battlefield. My farmer over here just chilling. Let's try a new god power on the next map. Let's resummon our farmer because our farmer is 100 or actually less than 150 points. Now we have a whole bunch of farmer factions. I need a new god power. So we're not going to do the M16 bullet. The M16 bullet we've already done. And that's easy. We're going to find something else. M16 we just did, but bazooka rockets. Okay. Let me just do slow-mo tap. Hold on. Wait a second. One, the bazooka rockets have a trail of fire. That's cool. But why are the bazooka rockets going? Oh no. 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 Oh, our farmer died. Oh, that didn't go so well. Why do the bazooka rockets do that thing where they home into the middle of the map? That's so weird. So the bazooka rockets seem a little bit broken. Shotgun bullet, no. John Wick, we've already done gun bullets. We need something different. M16, no. Grenade. I like a good grenade. Let's put on death spray, shall we? Death spray, grenade. Oh, yes. Yes. Oh, yeah, baby. The grenades are shot as if out of a grenade launcher. And the super spray, hold on. Let me do maximum slow-mo. And then, oh, no. What have I done? What am I doing, guys? Look at all the grenades. Disregard my evil cackle. Allow me to, let me pause time and then prepare these grenades. I'm just going to blanket the battlefield in a beautiful carpet of wonderful grenade beauty. And I'm just going to go over here and get these hobbits and farmers that seem to have escaped my grenades. How dare you? Take a look at my lovely ring of grenades that are going to spread out and just destroy. How is anything still alive from this grenade god power? Let me just go back to a regular tap. All right, we're just going to do a regular tap. And we're going to see what's alive. Where's my farmer? Farmer, there you are. Who's alive? Oh, there's a couple people over here. Let me just shoot this guy with a grenade right there. Oh! It's almost more beautiful when you only have one grenade doing the job. Hey, Glary. Glary and dude. Larry wearing no clothes. Remember that episode? Enjoy a grenade. Glary's still alive. I'm going to shoot right out of the air. Boom! She's alive. I'm going to shoot out of the air. Boom! Still alive. I think she's dead now. So who is... Oh, there's another Glary. Let's get this person out of the way. Go like that. I missed. Boom. All right, Glary body shot. You know, never mind. This Glary only needed the one shot. On to the next level! This one looks like Benny leading the charge of King Philip's armies. We have our lovely farmer over here. Let's find a sweet new power. Odin's spear projectile. Oh, I want to make use of this. Oh, I forgot about this one. Let's move to not death beam, death spray. And I'm just going to do slow mode. Start the fight, slow mode. And I'm just going to do one volley. There's one volley of what? Six of them? It has six arrows per volley. So if I hold down volley... Oh, I just changed to Mjolnir. I didn't want to change to Mjolnir. Oh, my bad. Go back to Odin's spear projectile. Apparently Alt also changes the projectiles. Death spray firing out a beautiful blanket of just bright fluorescent blue freezing power. Odin's spear projectile is probably the most powerful god power in the game. Only for one reason. If you guys have to figure it out, you'll understand what I mean. It is the most important god power. It is the most powerful god power because it freezes units. And if you have immortality on, it will still freeze them. Actually, let's test that theory. Make units not die, turn on. So now these units are incapable of killing each other, but I've got the Odin Spirit projectile. I mean, you always have like the arrow projectile, the ice arrow, but Odin Spirit just seems more powerful and more fast. It instantly freezes things. Let's see if this front line dies to the freeze. Yep, that's a whole boatload of dead units. So the ice arrow is like the slow version of Odin's spear projectile, or the Odin's spear projectile is the fast and instant version of what the ice arrows are capable of doing to any unit that is frozen solid. Let's just go over here, make sure all of our units are dead, and move on to the next level. Who is still alive? Oh, Benny. All right, now you're not able to kill Benny, Mr. Farmer. Sorry, Benny. Benny, I love you, buddy. I love you. You're my boy, and you've got messed up jug eyes, but get frozen. There we go. Even when units are immortal, the Odin Spear is the most powerful god power in the game. Oh, baby, the fireball skill. We have our lovely farmer. He is here, and over here, you've got, my goodness, everybody's here. A couple of Mini the Minotaurs, Lady Red Jade, Mr. Zeus himself, a couple of healers, some Cupids, some massive army. I've got the fireball, so slow mode activate, and I'm just going to fire the fireball. Now, one problem with the fireball is when I'm shooting, I can't see. The fireball is so big in my vision, unable to see where exactly I'm shooting with this god power, but it is gorgeous. Let's switch that to death spray so I can put it out in random directions. Death spray, maximum slow-mo. Oh no, maximum slow-mo makes an insane ball of fire. Oh, that is so fantastic. That is so fantastic. Allow me to use the stop time ability and do another death spray of fire. Oh, the fire was amazing. Fireball is so good. And this is from the Pharaoh unit from the mod. The Egyptian Pharaoh unit is the fireball. The barrel projectile was one of my instant favorites. Something about exploding barrels is just amazing. Death spray from above on Bjorn's army. I'm gonna fire out a whole bunch of exploding barrels in slow motion. Look at that. Allow me to launch a boatload more. Get it? A boat, barrel, pirate faction. Do you get the joke? It's a joke, guys. It does funny things. Allow me to get these guys in the front. Exploding barrels are cool. And then you've got the cutlass thrower, which is literally you throwing a boatload of swords. More boatloads. Look at these swords on these guys right here. Just amazing amount of god powers. Also, we also have this wizard explosion. I don't think it has been fixed. Actually, I can't even use it. The wizard explosion seems to be broken. No, I love the wizard explosion. It's my favorites. Death beam Mjolnir. Did he add lightning sound effects to Mjolnir? He may have added lightning sound effects to Mjolnir, but I'm not hearing, like, not doing any, like, cool lightning attacks with it. It's still just like an arrow. Mjolnir is pretty much an arrow, even in this update. It doesn't do any lightning, anything. Can I hit these guys in the sky with Mjolnir? Let's finish this up, shall we? I'm just gonna fire a insane amount. What's this death beam? I want to do death spray. There we go. We're going to do void arrows and finish up this impossible level. All these god powers are fantastic. They're made a little less cool because now everybody has access to god power using the default DLC. So they're less unique than what the mod gave us. But now you're able to modify the mod and improve upon the mod and make it even better. And the reason why I'm talking right now is I'm continuing to paint the battlefield with as many void arrows as I can in a death spray. So I'm just going to have like a million void arrows land on the battlefield and just wipe things out in 3, 2, 1, go. Slow mode. Down go the black holes. My God, how does anything survive that? What's alive? There's our farmer. Farmer's aiming over here at a single oarsman. Nope. There's something more than just a single oarsman. Oh no, yep. He's going after the single oarsman. Allow me. Now, oh no, there's another oarsman over here, or a berserker without a weapon. Is that it? Is someone left alive? Hello? Oh, another oarsman! Hey! Boom! There we go. We have one.